Africa. This is day two in the beautiful Moshi, and I have just now been picked up from my hotel by my friend here. Sorry, what was your name?
Bob Isaac.
Bob Isaac, right? So Bob Isaac has picked me up from my hotel, and we are just now driving to... well, I'm not going to tell you exactly where it is, because I know that there is a site here that is going to be very, very beautiful. And I want to surprise you with it, yeah? So I'm going to... When we see it, we see it. But we're just driving through the beautiful roads of... is this still Moshi that we're in?
Yeah,
we're still in the Moshi area. I'm going to turn the camera around in a minute, because we're just going over this kind of...
That is Moshi.
Oh, wow.
Logan, Phil, how high are we at?
Wow, yeah. Okay, let me just switch that around. I don't know if they're going to be able to see this, because sometimes the camera doesn't capture the beauty of the area. But yeah, you see, you know, one of the things that I'm struck by, and I keep telling you guys this, Tanzania has some of the most beautiful soil in the world. Yeah, that's why the plants are just amazing. And it's like everywhere we go, it's like the roads are just like red, the mud is red with life. Yeah, okay, so let me just turn the camera around so that you can see some of the terrain as we drive over the terrain, yeah?
Yenanza kama safari, tuende furani ukaone. Mena nguvu ni atari, ukisha nasa na uponi. Penaza kama safari, tunde furani ukaone. Mena nguvu ni atari, ukisha nasa na uponi. Mungu lumba dunia na majabu yake.
Check that beauty. Look. Right, now I'm going to just have a word with my driver here, because he's looking at the beauty too, and I don't want him to drive over the edge of this cliff, right? Little children. Is that Asabui?
Boys,
so that's a boy, Dada.
Signore, what? Grazie, grazie.
Io ne mi mafura. Io ne cose sarà. Io ne mi mafura.
This is my friend Emmanuel.
Yeah, Rich is Africa. TFT, Tanzania Flexible Time. Proud to be black. Welcome back to home, brother.
Yes, brothers and sisters. Remember, welcome back home, right? And this is... I've already introduced you to my driver, right? So we're going to just start heading out on this little trek, right? And if I understand correctly, we're going to be walking for a good... half an hour to 45 minutes. So I just wanted you to see a little bit of this landscape, and I'm kind of looking at the camera now, and again, this is one of those situations where It cannot possibly capture the beauty of the reality. You really have to come here and see this for yourself. In Jamaica, where my dad's from, there's a place called Trelawney. And Trelawney is kind of up in the hills, because Jamaica is a sort of volcanic island, yeah? So it's very, very hilly. And I remember when I sort of visited in Trelawney, and it kind of reminded me a little bit like this, but this is kind of on a sort of grander scale. And the soil here, you can tell that this is a better soil than in Jamaica. But it kind of reminds, because this is very hilly as well, you know? And it's very green and lush. That's what Trelawney is like.
It's called the flat-necked the chameleon or Garrison chameleon. For the male, they have two horns, female no. We have the other one, they call gecko, and male, they have three horns and rough face like the dinosaur.
Is it? Can I hold him?
Yes, no teeth. It's only long tongue for grabbing insects.
So he won't bite me?
For sure, no. No teeth. How can it bite?
While you're touching it? Put I'm scared, you know. Whoa!
It tries to.
Oh my God! What?
Adopting your
brain, brother.
What a strange feeling.
TIA, yeah.
It's a very,
Mr. TIA,
very strange feeling.
It's a very strange feeling when you feel his feet walk on you.
No, yeah. It's only long time.
Is it tickle? Is it tickle? Give me a kiss. Is it tickling?
And like coloration, it's a defense mechanism for it. So when you don't do the coloration, it's a normal situation.
Wow, like wow. I love that. The feeling is amazing.
I'm on body.
No, it's not heavy. Mama anakuuliza ni nzito, anataka ajaribu. Ni nzito. Hey, let's have to go. Say, Mama, there's some pelican in your body. Yeah. I am the assassin.
Village is called Materuni because 8% of the people are from the Materu clan. And by tribe, people we find in the slope of the mountain, we are called Chagga. And as Chagga, we grow banana as the best delicious cook. We grow coffee as the best product for us to sell. We grow corn or maize. And from corn is where we make our daily food. We call it ugali. Down where you can see, that is Moshi. The region is called Kilimanjaro, but down there, Moshi is the center of the Kilimanjaro region.
And so Moshi is where I can see the buildings, yes, right in the center of that.
Yes, and that's the center of the Kilimanjaro region. And according to the book history, Moshi has been founded in 1878 by the German. And the word Moshi has come that long time ago. We are having a good climatic condition, and people, they can't see town because of the fog. So since they don't speak English, they compare the fog with the smoke which coming from the kitchen. And the smoke, as we call it, Moshi. So the place where they can't see, they call it Moshi. You're welcome. Karibu.
So that's passion fruit, is it?
That's passion fruit or maracuya.
Maracuya.
Yes, and we have the avocado. And for the avocado, as we used to take the avocado fresh, but the tourists who come here, they teach us how to make guacamole from the avocado.
Well, I can tell you that this is a very young passion, because when I get passions in Dar es Salaam, they're very old and they're yellow and they've got to be very, how can I say it? You know, wrinkly, you know, like you've got smooth young skin.
Yeah.
And you've got very old wrinkly skin.
I get wrinkly.
So the skin of the passion fruit has got to be very wrinkly before you cut it open and you take the...
Because they keep it for a long time. Here, yeah. If you get some fresh one ripe, we can trade the fresh one from the trees.
So do you actually eat them when they're like this?
We don't know. Ours, this one, when they... this is totally different from the yellow one, you say. This one, this one is ripe, it turned black in outside, and it have some spot dotted. That we know that it's ripe.
Oh, so this is not the passion fruit that I eat when I'm in Dar es Salaam.
No, that's not the yellow one.
So, are the people who live around here predominantly vegetarians? I mean, do they eat a lot of meat, or...?
They eat a lot of meat, too. And most of the meat they eat here is like pork and beef.
Pork?
Yes.
So is the population not Muslim?
Here, the population is not Muslim.
What are they?
Most of the people here, like 99% of the people from the village, they are Christian. But when you go to a place like Moshi town, there is interaction. They have everything there. They have like Muslim, Christian, Orthodox. We also have the Masonic temple in Moshi.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Even Buddha.
So you have to dup his hair as well, yeah?
But for me, nature is my guide, and love the things which make me live.
Okay, that's why me and you naturally resonate with each other.
Sure.
Because I understand that nature is my God too. So you, when you said the Masonic thing,
yes.
I said that the duppies are here too. Duppies is a Jamaican word that they use for ghosts.
Yes.
And it's like people are kind of scared of duppies.
Yes.
So we kind of adopt that word when we're speaking about horrible people and people who are screwing the world up and people who are devilish and evil in nature. We just call them duppies. And you know, the Masonic order has got a lot to answer for.
Exactly,
yeah,
right.
they've caused a lot of pain and suffering in the world, and with what's happening with all this coronavirus shit that's going around. Yeah. The Masonic order are the vast majority of the people that are actually working on it. They're the foot soldiers.
That's yeah? Why I never take a vaccine. How is my hair? Never vaccinate myself. How is my hair?
You hear that, people? Hear that? You see, Africans have got a natural inbuilt defense mechanism. And that's the reason why these people have been trying to kill off Africans for thousands of years. And still we rise. This beauty will never be understood unless you see it. And as you can see, there's some water down there. Okay, let's continue.
The mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. Yimbo way, oh way.
Jungle, a quiet jungle, a lion sleeping tonight.
Imbuwe, 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 imbuwe.
See the waterfalls.
Oh my God!
Yeah, it's a good place for listening
TLC. Look, guys, look on the horizon. Can you see what I can see? Oh my God! Look, here is Chagga.
Kasi, speedy machine.
Kamata,
come on, I'm in and busy.
Kamata,
Polisi anashika mwizi kama dada. Oma, ya leo kiboko. Walita nikonya mako kisambu cha koko.
Right guys, so we've been trekking for probably about half an hour to 45 minutes. We've seen a lot of beautiful things along the way. It's one of those things, it's a little bit like having a baby. When you're doing the actual trekking, it's a little bit difficult, but once you get there, it's all worth it in the end. Ahead of me right now is one of the most beautiful sights I've ever seen in my life. And I think it's time for me to turn the camera around. It's going to take a good couple of minutes before we are at the bottom of this beautiful sight. So just let me turn the camera around and you've got to see this for yourself, okay? Look at that. Oh my God. Oh my God. You need to see it, everyone.
Singare Sira Jamba Singare Sira Kurumi Singare Sira Jamba.
Try and go underneath there. I just want you to understand the pain that I'm going through because I'm a man. I don't do cold. Yeah? I don't do cold under any circumstances. Right? I remember when I went to Jamaica and they didn't have any warm showers.
Yeah.
I didn't shower for 2 weeks. Right? Hey. I'm going to go under there and I'm going to taste some of this. Because this is Jaja. And unfortunately I can't turn Jaja down, yeah? Under any circumstances. Yeah? You carry on.
TFT, Tanzania Flexible Time. Welcome to Tanzania, no corona, all the way from UK to Kilimanjaro. Proud to be born in Africa.
Remember that, right?
Black Lives Matter.
There is no corona in Tanzania, yeah. Right? Love, peace out. Now, what I want you to understand is, this is of the glaciers that are up there on top of the mountain, right? So this is freezing cold water. I'm being very brave for what I'm doing. But anybody who knows me knows that I always come prepared, right? So, 1 second. Here we are.
Now we're gonna start by having our soup from the banana. We call it mtori. We just use green banana, potato, yams, and beef cooked together. Then we make something like a soup. And this is not a lunch, it's a starter to warm up your stomach before you have the real lunch. Karibu.
Right.
Welcome, sir. If you like spicy, pepper, chili,
we have
spice here.
Asante. Right, guys, I'm going to give you. I'm going to put a little bit of pepper in because I've got my water there. So if it's too much for me, I should be all right. But I'm going to give you an honest opinion. Oops, I think there's a bit too much pepper in that one. There you go. Oh, that's very, very nice. Very, very nice. They use onions in this, don't they?
Yes, onion, yeah. Carrot, ginger for the beef to make it light.
Mmm. This soup is really, really nice, guys. Mmm. And all that walking today really does make you hungry. Mmm, so nice. Oh, there's beef in this too. Look, there's little chunks of beef. Mmm.
So here we have the normal rice, we call it wali. We have the curd rice, we call it pilau. We have a beef sauce. Here we have spinach, paper, hot, spicy,
appetizer, pili pili ho ho.
Karibu.
And I just jump in and take whatever I want, yeah?
Exactly right, sir.
Okay, sounds good to me.
Yes, boy.
I don't know if it's because I'm extremely hungry because I haven't eaten a lot in the last 2 days, but this is extremely nice. And the spinach is very lovely, very juicy, but I really, really do like this beef stew. It's got so much flavour, it's packed with flavour. I'm going to put some little bit of pili pili with it, that's hot pepper. Mmm. Mm.
Kilimanjaro National Park. So we are near to Kilimanjaro here. And on the slope of the Mount Kilimanjaro, you just found the Chagga people. So we are Chagga in the tribe. So we as Chagga, we grow bananas. This is our best delicious cook. And we grow coffee. This is like our cash crop for us to sell. So all of
so on a tree, you will form some green berry and some their red one like this.
So you can take this one.
Where is the biggest export market for Tanzania
coffee? Back in Moshi there, we have the cooperative shop. We call it KNCU, Kilimanjaro Native Coffee Union. They buy coffee from the local people and they sell from big companies all over the world.
My parents are from Jamaica.
Yeah.
And in Jamaica, we have a place called Blue Mountain. I don't know if you've ever heard of Blue Mountain coffee.
Oh, Blue Mountain.
Blue Mountain coffee is meant to be the best coffee in the world. So I know absolutely nothing about coffee. I don't even drink coffee. So I'd be interested to know what makes coffee good and what makes
whatever,
coffee,
yeah? Exactly right. As Kilimanjaro, we believe we're just producing a better coffee, and our coffee have a difference. Like, as I told you, there are some types of coffee which you can't even shake them before the roasting. But after the roasting, that's where you can understand the coffee. Because for the organic Arabica coffee, to know that is better, when we boil the coffee, we don't stir it in the hot water in the cup. We boil with the coffee. And for the good coffee, it must bubble. So if you make your coffee, then the coffee doesn't bubble, that's not your real coffee.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
So are we going to taste some of this good coffee today?
Exactly right.
We have three shells. The first shell is the reddish one.
So this is the end result, guys.
You can take a kosher white paper. Mmm, smells lovely.
Saga. Kumbaya. 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 Kumbaya.
Oh, you just got to leave it, yeah?
Is it your daughter?
Right, so after that long and drawn out method of producing the coffee, what I have here is one completed cup. As you can see, it's black. We don't have any milk here, but I did have some brown sugar that I was able to add to it. So we're going to see how the raw coffee tastes with some brown sugar. Oh, very strong, very pure, very, very, it's very lovely actually. I mean, I've never been a coffee drinker. It's something that I've never really got into. I drink it on the occasion. I drink tea more than I do coffee, but this is really, really nice. It's very refreshing, very refreshing. It's very worth all the hard work, my guys. It was worth all the hard work.
It's a pleasure. You're
welcome. Speak to you later, folks. Love ya.
There's another one for the motherland. Yes, 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 there's another one for the motherland. Haba! 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 Check the intro, check the logo, I'm for the zone, boy. Make a link up with the gringo.